Good evening, everybody. It is Thursday, October 12th, 2023. It is 6:50 in the evening. Okay, so this is what I got for you for this video. Part 3 or 4 of The Mark. Chapter 1. David finally reached Sector 53, which was, as he had been told, deserted. The crowd control gates had toppled, and the giant number placard had been trampled. David sat there, forearms resting on the cart's steering wheel. He shoved his uniform cap back on his head and felt the sting of the sun's UV rays. His hands looked like lobsters, and he knew he'd pay for his hours in the sun, but he had not find... But he could not find shade again until he found Annie. As crowds shuffled through then around what had been his sector, David squinted at the ground, the asphalt shimmering besides the ice cream and candy wrappers and drink cups. That lay motionless in the windless heat was what appeared to be residue of medical supplies. He was about to step from the cart for a closer look when an elderly couple climbed aboard and asked to be driven to the airport shuttle area. "This is not a people mover," he said absently, having enough presence to remove the keys before leaving the vehicle. "How rude," the woman said. "Come on," the man said. David marched to Sector 53 and knelt, the heat sapping his energy. In the shadows of hundreds walking by, he examined the plastic empties of the bandages, gauze, ointment, even tubing. Someone had been ministered to here. It didn't have to have been Annie. It could have been anyone. Still, he had to know. He made his way back to the cart, every seat but his now full. "Unless you need to go to medical services," he said, punching the number into his phone, "you're in the wrong cart." In Chicago, Rayford Steele found the strong building's ninth floor enough of a bonanza that he was able to push from his mind misgivings about Albie. The truth about his dark little Middle Eastern friend would be tested soon enough. Albie was to ferry a fighter jet from Pulwalki to Kankakee, where Rayford would later pick him up in a global community helicopter. Besides discovering a room full of the latest desktop and mini computers, still in their original packaging, Rayford found a small private sleeping room adjacent to a massive executive office. It was outfitted like a luxurious hotel room, and he rushed from floor to floor to find the same next to at least four offices on every level. "We have more amenities than we ever dreamed," he told the exhausted tribulation force. "Until we can blacken the windows, we'll have to get some of the beds into the corridors near the elevators, where they can't be seen from the outside." "I thought no one ever came near here," Chloe said, Kenny sleeping in her lap and Buck dozing with his head on her shoulder. "Never know what satellite imaging shows," Rayford said. "We could be sleeping soundly while GC security and intelligence forces snap our pictures from the stratosphere." "Let me get those two to bed somewhere," she said, "before I collapse." "I've moved furniture in my day," Lee said, slowly rising. Where are these beds and where do we put them?" "I wish I could help," Chaim said through clenched teeth, his jaw still wired shut. Rayford stomped him with a gesture. "If you're staying with us, sir, you answer to me. We need you and Buck as healthy as you can be. And I need you alert for study," Sion said. "You made me cram for enough exams. Now you're in for the crash course of your life." Rayford, Chloe, Lee, and Sion spent half an hour moving beds up the elevator to makeshift quarters in an inner corridor on the 25th floor. By the time Rayford generally boarded, the chopper balanced precariously on what served as the new roof of the tower, everyone was asleep, save Sion. The rabbi seemed to gain a second wind, and Rayford wasn't sure why. Okay, so that is all that I've got for you for this video. If you like this content, like this video, or comment below. Thank you very much. And now don't forget to go out there and rainbow it. Flood the world with love, peace, joy, and charity. Thank you, and have a good day.